Yeah, there is lots of positive moments. I think that's, yeah, that goes without saying. I mean, you know, we could list probably 10 really good moments where, you know, fans, players, staff were all very excited about. You know, and I just go back to that first game and that first, you know, first victory for the club. You know, to do that in your first match is something that we were particularly proud of in the locker room post game.
I don't think it could have started any better. You know, one, it was a 3-0 win, it was a shutout. We scored our first goal, I think, 2 minutes in, and then JJ scored again in the 10th minute, and we're like, wow, what is going on? So, I mean, it was super fun, it was exciting. There was a lot of, you know, I guess nerves and stuff, because it's the very first game. You're like, how are we gonna do? You know, we wanna do well for the city, and I guess we just came out flying. So it was one of the more fun games that I've played in, especially because it was such a historic moment for the club.
You know, I've thought about it over the season. If it was good that we went and won, you know, 3-0, you know, which is a convincing win. But, you know, I mean, you always take a win when you can take a win. You know, it was a good confidence builder for guys. Maybe an unrealistic ideal of how the team was going to go throughout the year. But I already had my mind set on certain things that would happen throughout the year. You know, there was going to be times where we're winning, times that we're losing, just because of everything that's kind of come together in a short amount of time.
And just another in a long line of injuries. No Araujo, no Ching, no Reed, no Francois, no Palacios, and now no Ford and no McCarthy.
This is probably the first time I've been on a team where we've had so many significant injuries, all different injuries in one season, so that was obviously unfortunate for those players and obviously for us because they're very good players.
Yeah, look, I mean, teams go through that, right? But the camaraderie and the team spirit of the players has been great. I mean, you know, when you go in that locker room, they generally get along, they genuinely like each other, and we'll you know, do anything for one another. And that's something that, you know, you can be especially proud of because you have that family type atmosphere.
Honestly, all the bad things that happened injury wise, knowing that we were together, it meant a lot.
The group really started coming together probably more when you see, I mean, Josh was our captain. You know, you see your captain go down. And then not only that, our starting center back is down literally in the same game. So when you see all that stuff happening, the only thing you can do is really rally together. Everyone's going to look down and be like, oh, they're losing some of their best players. They're out for the count. But we didn't look at it that way.
We believed we could do it. We believed each person that came in, you know, because we lost a lot of players. Matt was huge when he came in, you know, for Josh, that Josh got hurt. You know, we lost Steve and Sam, and then Ryan came in. You know, they came in big, you know, as center backs, that Ryan hadn't played a minute to the last games.
You know, it was a next man up mentality kind of thing. And the guys that have been playing a lot, we try to help the guys get up to speed when it's like, listen, this is your time now. Who cares if you weren't starting before? Like, this is your time to shine.
I thought it was good that guys were going ahead and, you know, stepping up in times when they needed to. Darren did well with giving guys a bunch of minutes around, you know, in the season. So if we came down to circumstances like that coming towards the end of the year, guys have played.
You know, when a particular player goes down, whether it's Josh and then Matt steps in, we also deputized a couple of times earlier in the year and done a good job. And then, you know, the same with the centre-backs. You know, the reason you have 3 and 4 centre-backs on a team is in case somebody gets injured, somebody may get suspended, and then the next guy has to be ready. So their readiness comes from, you know, daily practice. You know, what the fans don't see is, you know, the guys that necessarily don't play on a Saturday night are in Sunday mornings training, you know, extremely hard and just waiting for their opportunity. And that's what drives it. We want it to be as competitive as possible. So the guy that, you know, may get to start on any given Saturday, you know, knows that somebody breathing down his neck that wants his jersey.
Obviously, we didn't make the playoffs, which was unfortunate. You know, we all set out to, one, make the playoffs and then make a run deep in the playoffs. But, you know, sometimes it just doesn't go the way things were planned.
It was bitter because we didn't achieve what we wanted. You know, it was a goal that we had and we didn't achieve. But like you said, we had so many injuries that pushed us back. But at the end of the day, we can't make excuses, you know. You know, I think what we did is, you know, we put what San Antonio FC is about and, you know, hopefully next year, you know, we do much better.
Yeah, I know it was a first-year team and everything, and you kind of always had that excuse of, it's a first-year team, it was just put together, but I never really looked at it that way. We have a bunch of guys here that have played the game before, both professionally. Obviously, we have all different experiences, so all of us coming together that way, I didn't look at us as a first-year team.
It's been a whirlwind. I mean, it really has. You know, from day one, it's just hit the ground running, and it came to a big halt when we didn't get the result we wanted on Saturday, and that's hard to take. I mean, that's hard to take right now, because you're working towards that all year, and then in one moment, it comes to a stop, and you know, we've got work to do, and you know, that process starts. You know, for me, as that final whistle goes, my head's already spinning and going, okay, we don't want to be here next year. How, you know, what do we need to do to improve? What do we need to do to make this better? And you know, let's make sure we have that consistency next year. But one word for this year, manic.
We've been through everything, you know? There's nothing else that could happen next season that you're not ready for. It's something that next year, it's not such thing as you're gonna be close. It's like, we're gonna make sure we make the playoffs.